Okay, today we're going to remove the front axle CV joint on a 2013 BMW X3. Very easy way to do it. Unless you have play in your ball joints, there's three of them here. Unless you got play or they're ripped and you're replacing them, you don't have to touch none of them. It's very simple to do. Okay? What you're going to do is the tools you're going to need. Impact gun or a breaker bar, a 17 millimeter hex drive, 18 millimeter socket, a lock wrench, a big punch, and a hammer. So what you're gonna do, come around here, 17 millimeter, you take that out. If your impact's not strong enough, you can use, you know, like a wedge screwdriver in between the vent over here, you know, in between the brake rotor, and break it loose with a breaker bar. But you're gonna need that special 17 millimeter. Not everybody has them. All right. Once you get that off, you take it off. You're gonna come to the back over here. You see this arm? You're gonna put a lock wrench. This is 18 millimeter. You're gonna take that off, but there's a bolt in back. Actually, this is the bolt. You hold that with the lock wrench and you take the nut off right here, 18 millimeter. All right, you get that out of the way. I loosened it already. Okay, go back over here. Okay, now what that does, swings this whole thing over. You see this? Let me zoom it out. See? It swung the whole thing over, and you'll be able to get that CV joint out with no problem. Okay? You take this off. And be careful. It has like a little spring in there and a little O-ring. Just make sure you, just put it back the same way you took it off. Okay, and now it's actually just about out. Oh, it already came out. Okay, so now what you're gonna go over here. Let me back up a little bit. If your pan, you're probably gonna have a pan that's on here, the big splash pan. Basically, they're all 8 millimeter bolts. You find which ones they are that go all the way around and take it down. Just enough access so you can get to the axle. Which is right here. See the axle right here? And what we're gonna do is we're gonna hit it with the punch and a hammer and pop it out of its spring. There's a spring, it's spring loaded. And what you do is just hit it with a hammer until it comes out, and that's it. And it'll come right out. I'll show you. Okay, basically you put right here, in the corner, as straight as you can, hit that with a hammer, and it pops it out. You see that? You're gonna get some leakage over here. Just put something on the bottom to catch it. And, you know, it's good to have a container, nice clean container, so whatever came in, you know, you can put right back out. I mean, whatever came out, you can put right back in. All right? And it just slides right out. Okay, so unlike other axle shafts, see, you just slide this out of the way. And it'll come out. It's not that long, see? It's actually splined in there. You see that? So the pressure of the bolt that holds it against the hub is what, see, it's not a long thing, so that's why it comes out that way, and you have plenty of room when you move this out of the way. Just watch the brake line, but no, you're good. You're good, you got plenty of room. And now all I'm gonna do is just tap it out, and that's it. There's a better view of the back. You see that, how it just goes in there, locks in those little grooves right there? It's still leaking out a little bit. That's right here. See?
And that's it. And same thing with the other side if you have to do both.
And that's what it looks like when it comes out. It's nice and long. This is a long one. But like I said, you got plenty of room to pull it out. Yeah, see? That's what it looks like there. And that's it. And do the same thing to the other side. All right, guys, Motor Car Nut, please hit that like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.